Hello students, I am Sathya Prakash. Welcome to Cars Physics. We are continuing chapter number 2, Electric Potential and Capacitance. Okay, in previous lectures, we have discussed different methods how to find equivalent capacitance in combination of capacitors. Okay, so we have discussed different methods, different concepts to find equivalent capacitance in combination of capacitors. Okay, so in this lecture also we will discuss another method which is very easier method. Okay, and that method is called as charge distribution method. Okay, charge distribution method. So under this concept, we will discuss how to find the equivalent capacitance in skeleton cube of capacitors. Okay. So using this concept, using the concept of charge distribution method, we will learn how to find the equivalent capacitance in skeleton cube of capacitors. So in this lecture, I will try to explain at least two cases on skeleton cube of capacitors. Okay, two cases means depending upon the terminals. Okay, so as we have discussed, we have to find capacitance between A and B or between P and Q. Then in those cases, we do assume that point A is connected to positive terminal and point B is connected to negative terminal. Okay, so what happens actually, suppose this is a capacitor of capacitance C. So this is uncharged. Initially this capacitance has no charge, means there is no potential difference between these two plates, an uncharged capacitor. So we will connect the plates to positive and negative terminals of a cell. So this is positive terminal, net potential is V1. This is negative terminal, net potential is V2. So V1 is a high potential and V2 is low potential. Now the circuit is on or the circuit is closed. So what happens actually? This is metallic plate. So initially this plate is uncharged. So if this metallic plate is connected to positive terminal, what will happen? What will happen then? This is neutral connected to high potential, means positive potential. So the free electrons in this metal plate will get attracted towards positive. Okay. So electrons will be removed from this plate and accordingly this plate will acquire positive charge and induced charge will be on the inner side of this plate and we may use arcing. Okay, and the charging process continues till potential difference between the plates of capacitor becomes equal to potential difference between the terminals of the cell. This is how charge is distributed. Okay, so what happened actually? Electrons are removed from this plate and moved towards positive, but what we assume, equal quantum of positive charge flow from positive to or high potential to this plate. Okay, this plate is connected to positive terminal. Then our basic assumption is equivalent amount of positive charge flows from positive terminal to the metallic plate. But practically electrons play great role for charging the capacitor. But conventionally we may assume equivalent amount of positive charge flow. Okay, we have already discussed it. Then we will go through the method of charge distribution, and as I have told you, in this lecture I will try to explain at least two cases on skeleton cube of capacitor to find equivalent capacitance. Let's start. Okay, very easy and highly conceptual. So I have written, this is part 12 of the discussion to find equivalent capacitance in combination of capacitors. So let's start. Let's take a skeleton cube. Okay. Let's frame. This is a skeleton cube. Okay. Each arm of the cube contains capacitor of capacitance C. This is C. Okay. Each arm contains a capacitor, and each of capacitors let C. Okay. This arm also contains capacitance C. This is also capacitance C. So how many capacitors? In skeleton cube, this is 4, this is 4, and this is 4. 1, 2, 1. So total 12 number of capacitors. Each of capacitance C are used in skeleton cube of capacitor. Let's first find capacitance between the ends of main diagonal of the cube. So equivalent capacitance between the ends of main diagonal of the cube. See, suppose I will write like this. This point is Q. Okay. So if you join from P to Q, just imagine the three-dimensional view. Then if you join from P to Q, then this will be main diagonal. We have to find equivalent capacitance between P and Q. Between P and Q, we have to find equivalent capacitance between the ends of main diagonal. Okay, this is our end. Okay, then this point is P, this point is Q. Okay, let's name all the corners. This is A, this is B. This is a B. We'll not use C because C we have taken capacitance. Okay. Similarly, this is M, this is L, this is let O. Any name you can use, any name. Okay. We have named like this, but we have to find the equivalent capacitance between P and Q. So what's our basic assumption? Let's assume P is connected to positive terminal of a cell, and Q is connected to negative terminal of the cell. Okay, P is connected to positive terminal and Q is connected to negative terminal of the cell. Then conventional charge starts flowing from P. Okay, this is the total charge which flows from positive terminal to P. So when the charge reaches at P, then obviously this will be divided into three branches. When charge reaches at P, total charge Q is divided into three branches. We are considering conventional flow of charge. Total charge reaches at P and is divided into three branches. Then let's start from P. We have to find capacitance between P and Q. Let's start from P. P is connected to positive. So these three capacitors, C, C, C. Okay. Charge is distributed in these three capacitors. So where there is division of charge, as we know, then the capacitors are in parallel. So from P, this total charge is divided into three branches through the capacitors C, C, C. So these three capacitors obviously are in parallel. Where there is division of charge among the capacitors, then the capacitors are in parallel, as we have already discussed. Okay. Then let's arrange these capacitors. This is C. And this is C. Okay. Total charge from P is divided into three branches. So these three capacitors are in parallel. Then C, point Q. If total charge is Q, conventional charge is Q starts from positive, then total charge Q must be circulated, means enters through negative terminal. So total charge Q, of course, let's take it small Q, okay. Then this is small Q, okay. This small Q must be from Q. This total charge Q starts from P and again comes out from Q. So if this is point Q, then this charge, this charge, this charge, sum of these three charges must be Q. So here total charge is distributed in these three capacitors, and here at point Q total charge is collected at Q through these three capacitors. Again, these three capacitors may be taken in parallel. So again, let's start from Q. This is Q. Then these are the three capacitors, 1, 2, and 3 in parallel. Okay, very easy. See. We have completed these three capacitors, 1, 2, 3, and these three capacitors, 1, 2, 3. Then we have taken 6 capacitors. Then again, see. The total charge Q is divided into 3 branches. Again, the charge through this capacitor, again divided into 2 branches. Charge through this capacitor is again divided into 2 branches. Charge through this capacitor is again divided into 2 branches. So these 3 branches, charge through these 3 branches again divided into 6 branches. 1, 2, 1, 2, and 1. These 6 capacitors must be in parallel. Okay. So total charge in these 3 capacitors, total charge means Q through these 3 capacitors must be equals to total charge in these 6 capacitors, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Total charge through these 3 capacitors must be in these 6 capacitors. Then from these 3 capacitors, this total charge Q, this total charge Q is divided again in 6 capacitors, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then this charge Q is again through these 3 capacitors. So now we have taken 6 capacitors. This is 6 number of capacitors, and total, this is 3, this is 3. Then total 12 number of capacitors are arranged. Then, now it is very easier. Again, let's start from P. Okay. Sum of these 3 capacitors are in parallel, C, C, C in parallel. So obviously, total capacitance is 3C. So these 6 capacitors, sorry, this one, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So these 6 capacitors, they are in parallel, then 6, 6, then these 3 capacitors in series, then 3C, and finally, we do reach up Q. Okay. Now, equivalent capacitance between P and Q, 3C, 6C, and 3C are in series. Then equivalent capacitance between P and Q in series, sum of reciprocal of capacitors is equal to reciprocal of equivalent capacitance 1 by 3C plus 1 by 6C plus 1 by 3C. Now the solving is very easy. Then LCM is 6C and it is 2 plus 1 plus 2. So this is 5 divided by 6. Then equivalent capacitance is 6 by 5C. Okay. This is our answer. Equivalent capacitance is 6C by 5. Equivalent capacitance is 6C by 5. Okay. Between the ends of main diagonal of the skeleton cube, each arm containing capacitance C. Okay. Then another case. This is a two general case and a common case. Okay. And erasing the diagram. It's not looking so good. Just
follow the method, just follow the method, division of charge, and again you will find easier.
And we now know also, potential method that also helps in finding equivalent capacitance most easily. And also we have discussed about symmetry of circuit, that one also very important factor of.
Let's again represent case 2. Case 2.
Let's take
skeleton cube of capacitor. Just draw a skeleton cube, then we'll take capacitances. Each arm containing capacitance C, this is C. This is C, this is C, this is C, this is C, okay, this is C, C, and this is C.
So, core for 8,
this is C, this is C, this is C. And finally, this is also C.
Okay. In this case, so we will find, let this point is P, this point is Q. Okay. So we have to find capacitance between P and Q. Okay. Capacitance between the ends of one side of the skeleton cube. Capacitance between the ends of one side of skeleton cube.
So capacitance between P and Q. Let's argue. This is P, this is Q. P is connected to positive terminal and Q is connected to negative terminal of the cell. Again, conventional charge let Q from positive terminal. Conventional charge is Q from positive terminal. Okay.
So see, P is connected to positive terminal, Q is connected to negative terminal. Between P and Q, this is one capacitor. And we will take other capacitors gradually. This is the basic assumption. P is connected to positive and Q is connected to negative. Okay. See. Between P and Q, we will find capacitors between P and Q. Between P and Q, this is the capacitor. Let's represent it first. I am representing here. This point is P. This capacitance is C and this point is Q. Okay. We have taken this capacitor only. Then from P, see, if conventional charge reaches at Q, then through these two branches, charges are divided. Okay. Charge directly. We may take conventional flow of charge in one branch from P to Q also. These are two different branches in which also charge is divided. So from P, these two capacitors, charge is flowing from P through these two capacitors. So charge is divided through these two capacitors. So these two capacitors must be in parallel.
So from point P, let's represent this capacitance is C, this is C, and this is also C. Both are connected in parallel. Okay.
Then come to Q. Again, charge must enter at Q. Through these two branches, charge will enter at Q. Okay. Conventional flow of charge from positive to negative. Okay. So these two capacitors must be parallel with the charges are divided. So from Q, these are the two capacitors, this one and this one. Capacitances are C and C. Okay. Do like this, it is the easiest method. Okay, it is the easiest method. Okay.
We have taken from P these two capacitors. We have taken from Q these two capacitors. Okay. Let's name this is X. Let this is arbitrarily name This is X, this is Y, this is R, this is X, this is L, this is L.
Name arbitrary. Okay. Then, from P, there are two capacitors between P and R, between P and X. From symmetry of the circuit, potential at R must be equal to potential at X. See, from P, there are two branches, these two branches, now we are considering this is separate. Okay. So, potential at X is equal to potential at R. So, these two capacitors, we have taken these two capacitors. So, potential at R is equal to potential at X. So, this point may be taken as Rx. Potential at R is equal to potential at X. So, we have taken a common point from symmetry of circuit. Similar, if you consider point Q, these are two capacitors. So, between Q and S and between Q and Y, these are the two capacitors. So, S and Y from again symmetry of circuit, S and Y are at same potential. So, this point may be taken as S and Y. S and Y. Do you understand? Is it easier? Okay. From P to R, from P to X, so potential at R is equal to potential at X. These two capacitors we have taken. This is R, this is X, both are at same potential. If we consider Q, these are the two capacitors between Q and S, between Q and Y. Again, S and Y have same potential. We do take a common point. Okay. Then, move to MN. Okay. First we have taken between P and Q. Let's take now M and N. Okay.
This is N. This is capacitance C. And this is N. Okay. Between M and N, this is the capacitance C. We have taken it. This is capacitance C.
Again, let's see from M.
Between M and R, capacitance is C. Between M and X, capacitance is C. Since R and X are at same potential, from M to R and from M to X, these two capacitors must be in parallel. These two capacitors between MR and MX must be in parallel. Okay. So, again let's take from M, this is C. And both are connected to a common point Rx, since potential of R is equal to potential at X. Similarly, from N, this is a capacitor, this is a capacitor. Between N and S, capacitance is C. Between N and Y, capacitance is C. So S and Y are at same potential. So between N, X, N and SY, between N and X, SY, there are two capacitors, and obviously these two capacitors are in parallel. So let's again represent C from N and connected to SY. From N connected to SY. Now it is easier. Just arrange the capacitors, redraw the circuit themselves. Okay. Now let's simplify it. We have to find capacitance between P and Q. This is P, this is Q, this capacitance is C, then from P, this capacitance C and C are in parallel, so total capacitance is 2C, C plus C, 2C from Q. Again C and C in parallel, then total capacitance is 2C, C. We have reached, this is Rx, we have reached, this is S, Y. Again, between Rx and M, again two capacitors in parallel. So let's take this point is M. So C and C in parallel, again capacitance is 2C connected to Rx. M and Rx, between M and Rx, capacitance is 2C. Similarly, between N and SY, capacitance is 2C. This is M. This capacitance is 2C connected to S and Y. Okay. And finally, between M and L, capacity consists C. Now it is very easy. Okay. And this implies the C.
O. 2 to 4 to 6 to 8. Okay. 4 for 8 to 10. Okay. Another two capacitors we have not joined yet. C. Between C. R. This is X. This is R. This is X. Both are at same potential. Okay. And S and Y are at same potential. So which capacitor we have left? We have left this capacitor between R and S, between R and S, and we have left this capacitor between X and Y. Okay. Since R and X have same potential, S and Y are at same potential, there are two capacitors between R and S and between X and Y. These two capacitors between R and X are S and Y. We do represent like this. This is C and this is C. Okay. Connector S1. So, between Rx and Xy, this is C, this is C. Both are in parallel. So, total capacitance is 2C. Okay. Now, again, rearrange the circuit. Between M and L, capacitance is C. Okay. This is M. This is M. M and L. So, now, again, let's take like this. This capacitance, okay. You may add 2C, C and 2C. These three. 1, 2, 3. These three obviously in series. These three capacitors in series. 2C and 2C. In series. So what is the equivalent capacitance C? Again, C and C. 2C and 2C. In series. 2C, C and 2C. All these three in series. 2C and 2C in series, then total capacitance is 2C by 2C. Again, C and C. These two combination of these two is C. Again, this is C. C and C in parallel. So, equivalent capacitance is C by 2. Sum of these three capacitors, 2C, C and 2C in series. So, equivalent capacitance is C by 2. So, this is Rx. This is 2C. And this is SY. Okay. Finally, again, rearrange the circuit like this. This is 2C, this is C, and this is 2C. This point is P, this point is Q. We have to find capacitance between P and Q. P and Q. Okay. You just see, this is C by 2, this is 2C. C by 2, 2C. So C by 2 and 2C are in parallel. C by 2 and 2C are in parallel. So what will be the capacitance? C by 2 plus 2C. That's equals to 2C plus 4C. That's equals to 5C by 2. Okay. 5C by 2. Sum of these two is 5C by 2. Okay. Let's say again. Redraw the circuit like this. The sum of these two is 5C by 2. Again, this is 2C, this is C, and this is C. This point is P, this point is Q. Okay? Again, these three capacitors in series 2C, 5C by 2, and 2C. In series, so can I erase one of the diagram? I am erasing the main diagram. Okay? We have already rerun the circuit in different ways. C. 2C, 5C by 2 and 2C are in series. Then equivalent capacitance, let's say C dash of these three capacitors, C dash, that equals to 1 by 2C plus 1 by 5C by 2 plus 1 by 2C. So 1 by C dash is equal to 1 by 2C plus 2 by 5C plus 1 by 2C. So 1 by C dash is equal to, it is 10C. So it is 5 plus 4 plus 5. Okay. Then 1 by C dash is equal to 14 by 10C, and C dash is equal to 10C by 14, and finally we will get it 4C
5C, 5C, 5C.
So some of these three capacitors in series, let's take,
this is 6.
Some of these three capacitors in series we found
5C by 7. Okay.
And finally this is C.
This is C between B and Q. Okay.
Just see. Now these two capacitors in parallel, 5C by 7 and C are in parallel. Now we will get equivalent capacitors.
I am erasing this and this is our final diagram.
Equivalent capacitance between P and Q.
This is equivalent capacitance between P and Q. So equivalent capacitance is 5C by 7
and C in parallel, just take algebraic sum. So 7, 5C
plus 7C, that's equals to 12 by 7C.
So this is our answer. Equivalent capacitance between P and Q is 12C by 7. Okay, just divide the charges into different branches and think about potential method also, as we have discussed. Rx are at a common potential and Sy are at a common potential. So there are different cases. It may be asked to find capacitance between the ends of diagonal of a face of any face, diagonal of any face of skeleton cube. Capacitance between the ends of any one face of the skeleton cube. I am showing you, of course, I have committed to do it's two numericals. Let's extend it. Just see the method. Okay?
Just see the method. These are very important and highly applicable questions for competitive exams in different ways. Questions may be asked, and all these forms are very, very, very easier. Just if you obey the method. Division of charge and potential method. Okay. I am representing the seat. This is a skeleton cube. I am not so good in diagram. Okay. This is seat. This is seat. This is seat. This is also C. Okay. This capacitance is C. 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 C.
Okay. Let's count 12 number of capacitors. Okay. So we have to find capacitance between the ends of diagonal of any face. Ends of diagonal of any face. Okay.
Let's take this is P, let's take this is Q. See, this is the diagonal of any face. You may take this face also, you may take this face also, any face.
Method is same. So we have to find capacitance between P and Q. Let's say again, Ajit.
P is connected to positive terminal and Q is connected to negative terminal of the cell. Then flow of charge. Conventional flow of charge from positive terminal and reaches at P. Okay. So just think about these two branches. From P, these two branches. Also, this is a branch. We'll take it later. Name it first. Suppose this is A. This is M. This is A. This is B. This is B. This is E,
will not take C because C is the capacitance. Okay.
So I am erasing the connection. Just let assume P is connected to positive and Q is connected to negative. So conventional flow of charge starts from P, divided into three branches. Just see these two branches. Okay. Space is too short. I am doing here. Let's start from P. This is one capacitor, this is one capacitor. So these two capacitors obviously in parallel. Similarly, charge will start from P, again charge will come out from Q. So think about these two branches, means this capacitor and these capacitors. Joining to Q, if you take this point is Q, then these two capacitors are in parallel, C, and C, connected to Q. Then again, this one is also a capacitor between P and A, between P and A. So if you take this is also a capacitor between Q and D, between Q and D, between Q and D, between P and A. Okay. Let's take this point is A. Between P and A, this is the capacitor. Between Q and D, between Q and D, between Q and D, this is the capacitor. We have taken these two capacitors and also these two and these two. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. We have taken 6 number of capacitors, then about remaining 6. Then about remaining 6. 6. This point is A. This point is A. We have taken here A. From A, these are two capacitors. So these two capacitors are in parallel. So from A, let's take again two capacitors. C and C. Again, from D, these are two capacitors. Charge must enter at D. So again from D, direct to D. From D, this is, this is Q, okay, this is D, Q and D, this is the capacitor from D, these are two capacitors, okay, so how many number of capacitors we have taken, 2, 2, 4, 4 plus 2, 6, 8, 2, 10, okay, then, We have left which capacitors? So we have taken this capacitor, this capacitor, this capacitor, this capacitor. Okay. Between A and B. Between A and B. Have we taken B, point B? Have we taken point B? No, we have not taken B. Between A and B, we have left this capacitor. This capacitance is total we have taken 10. Okay. Total of capacitors we have taken 10, but 2 are left between A and B. Sorry, we have taken 2. Okay. We have taken A and B. These two capacitors we have already taken. This point is B. This point is E. Okay. So, from symmetry of the circuit, B and E are at same potential. This is B, this is E, are at same potential C. From D to B, from D to B, and from D to E, from D to E. So, two capacitors between B and B, these two capacitors, two capacitors between A and B, A and B. Okay. It is completed. Then, from P, these are two capacitors. This point is there, this point is there. Okay. So this point is there, and also this point is M because M and M are at same potential from P to these two capacitors, from Q, these two capacitors. Between Q and M, between Q and M, between Q and M, between Q and M, and also from between P and M, P and M, and between P and L. Okay. Then C, B and MN. B and MN. This is B, this is D, this is M, and this is M. Okay. Now, between B and M, between B and M, this is the capacitor which is left. This is the capacitor between B and M. And C, between E and M, between E and M, E and M, this capacitor is left. Okay. So these two capacitors are in parallel between B, E, C. Where is B? Where is B? Where is B? This is B. B and E, B and E, And N and L. N and L. Again, these are two capacitors. Just join it. Just join it. See. B and L.
Now it is easier. You can solve it very, very easily.
Okay.
Will I erase this now? We have rerun the circuit. Let's erase it.
Okay. Just the generator numerical, apply the fundamental. Okay. We have to find capacitance between P and Q. Don't forget that. Okay. Between P and P. These two are in parallel. Capacitance is 2C. We have reached the after LN. Again. These two are in parallel. 2C. We have reached the Q. Then from P to A. Then from P to A, capacitance is C, this is A. Then from Q to D, D, okay, this is D. From Q to D, this capacitance is C, okay. Between A and B, capacitance is C plus C to C, this is D. Between A and B, capacitance is 2C. This is B and E at same potential between B and D. Again, capacitance is 2C. Okay. Between B and NM, total capacitance is again 2C. Okay.
It is very easy. I will now erase this diagram because this circuit is again redrawn. Okay.
Now I can start from P. This is P. 2C. This is 2C. This is P. Okay. This is 2C. This is L. This is L. C and 2C are in series. Then C into 2C divided by C plus 2C.
C1, C2 divided by C1 plus C2, so this will come 2 by 3C.
So this total capacitance we will take like this, 2 by 3C. Joint. Again, this is 2C, this is C, these two are in series, then total capacitance will be, 2 by 3C.
We have to find capacitance between P and Q. Now it is become very, very easier. Okay?
Just for your clarification, you may take point P. This is P. You may take point Q. You may shift this same thing. You may keep here P or here P. If you take this is P, charge will get C. Charge will come and will get divided into two branches. Okay, this branch and this branch, okay. If you take point P, this one is point P, then again charge is divided into two branches. Okay, so now it is equivalent to balanced Wheatstone's bridge. 2y3c, 2c. 2y3c, 2c. Okay, so this is C1, this is C2, this is C3. This is C4, so C1 by C2 is equal to C3 by C4. The Lamb's condition is satisfied. So we may disconnect this. This is not in use because no charge will flow this through this capacitor. So now 2C, 2C by 3 and 2C by 3 in series. Okay. 2C by 3 and 2C by 3. This is P in series. So it will be C. 2C. By 3, 2C by 3, in series. So in series group of capacitance, equivalent capacitance will be C1 by 2. This is C1. This is also C1. Equal to that means 2 by 3C divided by 2 by 3C divided by 2. Then we will get it. C by 3. Okay. Then this is 2C. This is 2C. In series, the equivalent capacitance is C. Okay, 2C and 2C in series, equivalent capacitance is C, and this is Q. Then these two are in parallel. Then between P and Q, this is equivalent capacitance. then equivalent capacitances both are in parallel, Cy3 plus 6, so it will come 4Cy3.
2 easier. 4Cy3, this is 2 easier. So these are 3 cases on skeleton cube. I hope you have understood a lot. So practice it. Again, I will meet you in next lecture with some beautiful concepts. Thanks, students. Thanks for your support. Thanks.